microscopically. Ach. Our carimaria conflates a cornucopic terpsichore realism with the ubiquitously, also from the Latin, unimpeachable Players Theatre and the unquenchable Miss Sheila Steafel!
Felt very gold when she twanged her guitar. She sang like a nightingale, twanged her guitar, danced the cachuca, smoked a cigar. Oh, what a form, oh, what a face, and she did the fandango all over the place.
She sang like a nightingale, twanged her guitar, danced the cachuca, smoked a cigar. Oh, what a form, oh, what a face.
After the break of dawn.
promise you, ladies and gentlemen, you will see Miss Sheila Steafel once again later on in the programme, perhaps not quite so frustrated. But now, from Rotherham, the irrepressibly risible ribaldries of that Yorkshire relish, Mr. Duggie Brown!
Well, good evening. I'll tell you what I'm going to do, because tonight is a very, very suspicious occasion. Tonight, actually, I'm very proud to announce, is the grand opening of Mr. Chairman's wallet. So I thought, no jokes, tonight I'm going to dedicate some poetry. Right? They strolled through the meadow. Hey, aren't drunks daft? My brother-in-law, he was walking past the fairground and this man shouted, anybody want to have a go on the rifles? It's 3 shillings, 5 shots. He said, yes, please, I'd like to have a go on the rifles if I can, please. Thank you very much. So he paid his money, he got hold of the gun, he went, bah, 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 and he shot all these 5 things down. The fella gave him the first prize, it was a little baby tortoise. And he went away, he came back an hour later, he said, I'll have another go at that, please, 3 shillings, thank you very much. And he went, bah, 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 and he shot them all down again, and he gave him a beautiful tea set. He said, I don't want that. I want another one of those pies with a hard crust. He walked into this bar, he said to the barman, he said, excuse me, barman, please. Do you sell that draft bitter here? The barman said, we sell everything here, sir. We're very, very proud of that. He said, well, would you give me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 12 pints of that nice draft bitter, please? The barman said, 12 pints, so they just resolved. He said, yes, they just resolved. Be a good chap, thank you. So he got these 12 pints, he went, glug, 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 glug. He drank the lot. He said, barman, the man said, me, sir. He says, any of the three of you come here with. What about that Dussel mixed as well? The barman said, we sell everything here. He said, would you give me? The barman said, can't you count any higher than that? He said, of course I can. What? No jokes. Would you give me 12 pints of mix, please? And he said, for yourself. He said, yes, sir, just for yourself. There's a chap gun. And he drank the lot and he's just disappearing below the level of the bar. He said, barman, what about shorts? Do you sell shorts as well? He said, we sell everything, sir. He said, well, would you sell me a pair? I've just wet these. Forty music. Hey, what about poor old Fred? Ah, let's try that again. What about poor old Fred? There's a woman gargling at the back there. You know? Poor old Fred. Everything went wrong for Fred. All through his life, nothing ever went right. And then one day, he thought he'd cracked it. He married this beauty queen. Ooh. And they were going to Blackpool to have a nice holiday, and they had a terrible accident, and poor old Fred got killed. Finished up in heaven, you see, and he said to Peter, everything's gone wrong for me all through my life. Aww. And he said, I finally thought I'd made it. I married this beauty queen. She was a lovely girl, and I've never even seen her body. Aww. He said, do you think I could possibly go back and just have a look at her body just once? And Peter said, no, I can't do that. Because he's from Rotherham as well. He said, no, no, he said, I can't do that. No chance of that. Oh, no, he said, no. He said, please, just let me look once. He said, all right, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll send you back. I'll send you back as a bird. So he sent him back as a little sparrow. And this sparrow found its way to Blackpool. He's through this. He found his way back to Blackpool, where his wife was in the hotel, and the sparrow got perched, which is poor Fred. And he's on the windowsill like that. And his wife's in there, and she's just getting over her grief, and she took her dress off. And you know how sparrows' eyes go when they're excited? Look, I'll show you, watch. You've seen it now, I'll show these, look. And then she just took her underskirt off, and that was it. It was like... And then the cat got him. They strolled through the meadow. The sky was an azure blue. He opened the gate, and she slowly passed through. She did not thank him, for she did not know how. For he was only a farmer's boy, and she was a big brown cow.
From Ireland, ineluctable Iberian ecstasy. The liquescence. Limpidity of a late lark ascending. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Miss Patricia Cahill!
Bells in my heart and they're ringing. And do when you are far?
Endearing, enduring, diminutive, in infectious delight. Your own, my own, everybody's own, dear Arthur Askey! I think you'd better come down here because they can't see you behind that protuberance.
Isn't it blooming marvellous? That's tantamount to a rebuff. All right, come and do it yourself.
Well, can't see.
I'm a stranger in paradise. Hang on. Penny change. I blow the candle out at 9:30. Off we go. You must join in this. In our little village there has been a tragedy. Deary, deary me, such a terrible tragedy. Mary Ellen Bottomley today should have been wed. It's a good job that she didn't now, so everybody said. Mary Ellen at the church turned up, her ma turned up, and her pa turned up. her sister Gert, her rich Uncle Bert, and the parson in his long white shirt turned up. But no bridegroom with the ring turned up, but a telegraph boy with his nose turned up. Brought a telegram to say he didn't want to wed, and they'd find him in the river with his nose turned up.
All together!
A telegraph boy with his nose turned up brought the telegram to say he didn't want to wed, and they cried him in the river with his nose turned up.
There you are.
Last time, you won't be worried again. How do you like it so far? What a load of rubbish.
Well, now I'm going to sing you another song. I wrote this myself. This one has got a monologue. I'm very good at monologues. As a matter of fact, I get a lot of little monologues sent to me by different people, you know. I got one sent today. They stroll through the meadow. Oh, no, that's the wrong one, isn't it? What fun we have at our cantatas. But this one says, the prisoner sat in his lonely cell. He committed a deadly sin. The warder said, you've 1 hour of grace. He said, marvellous, send her in. Hey there, Albert. Come here, Albert. Come here, love. Give us my Foreign Legion hat. Dear old Albert. Isn't he lovely? What sort of a woman was Victoria, Albert? She lovely. Okay, let's go. Foreign Legion. Atmosphere. See the gang of ruffians come marching all the sand. Out of line and out of step, they haven't got a band. Fighting with the Arabs and our friend from La Belle France. If you dare to lag behind, you get kicked in the pants. Marching on to death or glory, knowing there are none to care. Just an elbow jest with whiskers on your chest. That's the life of the legionnaire. Recitation. It's a hell of a life in the Legion. When you're out in the desert, I mean. This story I'll tell you is clever. It's not only clever, it's clean. Our captain we hated like poison. He had a moustache like a bedsock. And what the men called him led me to believe that he had been born out of wedlock. He took us a route march and lost us. An obsolete map they had sold him. He said, listen, men, I don't know where to go. So every one of us told him. Now here I am, back entertaining, singing songs ancient and new, striving and straining to get a good laugh out of boss-eyed palookas like you. Marching with the Foreign Legion, marching on to who knows where. Just an elbow jest with whiskers on your chest. That's the life of the legionnaire.
Gentlemen, I'm going to depart now from my usual procedure. I have asked if I might bring an artist in who I think has very great potential. I am sponsoring her. She's very nervous. It's her very first professional appearance ever, and I do hope you'll take her to your hearts. Ladies and gentlemen, from my heart, I introduce, for your very warm welcome, for a very new performer, Miss Porphyria DeLille Brown!
Thank you.
Of course, Sheila, that was Sheila Steafel, and may heaven and my wife forgive me. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from Hungary, transcendent in high altitudinous intrepidity, the duo Violin! Ebullient, injuvenescent jocularity, the one and only Terry Scott!
I bet you're surprised. Shut up, coughing me. I bet you're surprised because I come on a stage, don't you? Because, you know, you just can't walk on a stage. You can't because before you come on a stage, you have to do something. Yeah. And I just done something. I've seen some of what you don't know. My mum's, she's had another baby. Yeah, she has another one. And my dad, he don't know anything about it because he's away at work, yeah. I hope I'm not alone when he comes in because I get the blame for everything that happens in our house. Yeah, and my auntie come to see the baby. She come because my auntie Nora, she come. And see, she lives... You don't know my auntie-in-law. She lives a long way away.
Ah!
And she had to sleep in the same room as me and my brother all night, yeah. And she got undressed in the same place, yeah, not the same time. Well, she couldn't, because she's not fat. God. Do you know she's got things to hold her up and things to hold her down and things to hold her in and out and all over the place? My brother says when she gets undressed, she has to go to bed, otherwise she'd fall down. And the vicar come, the vicar come. Aha! He come round, nosy old, and he come round. He come round because he wanted to fix a christening and then he wanted to know the name, I expect. But my mum's got a funny name for it, because I think I'm going to call it quits, but I... But there was everybody there. There was a vicar there and my auntie, so I thought, right, I'm going to stand in the middle of the floor and do something which will give a very big surprise. Because it was like a party, see? So I told him a joke, yeah. And my mum laughed and my auntie laughed and the vicar cried. Because it was about a bull. It was a daddy bull, and he was in a field, and he got three baby boy bulls in the field. And the daddy bull, he said to the first baby boy bull, he said, yeah. He said, what are you going to be when you grow up? And the first one said, I'm going to be a bull in a china shop. And he said to the second one, what are you going to be when you grow up? And the second one said, I'm going to be a bull in the army. And he said to the third one, what are you going to be when you grow up? And the third one said, ha, I said, I want to stay in the field with you for heifer and heifer. And now, ladies and gentlemen, my solo song sung. Thank you. For many years before the war, we used to go away and spend a jolly time beside the sea. But when the railway fares went up, at home we had to stay, because we hadn't got the LSD. But Father had a good idea to make the house look gay with railway posters posted on the wall. In every room there's lovely places like Deal and Douglas Bay, so now we never want to go at all. The seaside post down the home. We never want to journey by the phone. There's Brighton in the bathroom and Papa feels quite a swell, because he cuts his corns outside the Metropole Hotel. We've got Yarmouth in the pub and there's Yarmouth in the yard, and Bournemouth we put somewhere out the back. And in the little parlour where the ladies sit and chat, we've got Clacton with the accent on the clack. Seaside post is well known. We never from our doorstep want to roam. There's Worthing in the cellar where we keep the bottle stout, and Father goes in there sometimes to see the tide go out. We've pictures of the Isle of Wight along the garden path, from Cockland Bay to Ventnor's Golden Shore. And when the milkman comes and leaves his cans upon the step, you could almost fancy cows was at the door.
Ladies and gentlemen, there is really only just time now for the last chorus of all, which you all know, down at the old Bull and Bush. We give you, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Terry Scott, Mr. Arthur Askey, and the entire company. We give you Mr. Bernard Herrmann and his entire orchestra of exemplary auxiliaries. But this time, chiefly, yours!